So thank you for checking out this link. I'm just going to be doing a quick rundown of everything that you have to know about tutorials. I understand that this is a staple project for the academics committee. We've been offering this since almost time immemorial, almost every term, if not every term. And so while I have had my own fair share of experience in the tutorials, I recognize that you guys might be more informed than me of the nitty-gritty of some of the processes that we do here in tutorials. So let's get right into it. I'm Owen Servic. Okay, so maybe you have to preempt these bullets now because we know that tutorials has always been the response of LSS to the struggle of students when it comes to their academic load, incoming assessments, long tests, quizzes, you name it, we try to offer our help. So our game plan has always been traditionally facilitating the tutorial sessions in collaboration with SLife. Okay, so here are people who are probably more skilled than me when it comes to attending to the tutorial sessions. Our project heads, Edric and Jovin, our tasks in tutorials are in your good hands. Everything that you have to do here in tutorials is summarized in these three major steps. The specific tasks, like for example, preparation of the pre-acts, submission of the pre-acts, request for publicity materials, those tasks will just be specified and blotted out in your Gantt chart. So those are the specific tasks. This is just the overview of the tasks here in tutorials, the main ones. Number one, interest check. You have to know again which courses are most requested. Okay. And after consolidating with our tutors, who among them can accommodate those requested courses, we can proceed with our registration. And of course, our tutorial sessions after that. And most importantly, I think, because this will help us in our stake in the next tutorials again, consolidation and marketing. We have to consolidate our data, aggregate our data. How are we more advantageous than other tutorial activities that are provided from other organizations? And of course, marketing. Okay. As I was saying kanina, we have to become results-oriented when it comes to the operations here in tutorials because only by having results can we also effectively market. So number one is to find a way to measure or quantify improvements in the academic performance among our tutee pools. I understand that it's going to be a hard activity trying to follow up on our tutees, how they fared in the long test they have prepared for, but it's only some of the only ways how we can possibly also monitor our work that we've been doing here in tutorials. Is it really effective or we're just doing a charity work? Number two, we have to focus on delivering numbers again, and we have to, more importantly, platform sentiments which prove that tutorials helps. So aside from the numbers, we also need to showcase sentiments and opinions from the tutees themselves that the tutorials help them in their long tests. And number three, we need to differentiate with tutorial programs of other organizations. That also means that we have to really put into writing the advantages that other organizations have over us. And to do all those things, we have to keep in mind that tutorials should be a campaign. So for example, here, I just took these publication materials from the Biden-Harris campaign. But essentially, what this shows is you can use the numbers and the graphs to really send a message that tutorials works, okay? So here are more examples. Basically, what this shows you is a visualization of the data that we can aggregate in our tutorial sessions. Perhaps we can make a publication material where we can put a side-to-side comparison of their grades before availing our tutorial sessions and after the tutorial sessions. So that way we can attribute a cause and effect relationship to our tutorial sessions, that our tutorial sessions do improve the academic performance of our tutees. So the work that we have to do, number one, pre-acts. I'll just be sending you the template that you can easily fill. And I don't think that it's going to be a major challenge to complete the pre-acts for tutorials because we've historically been doing this. Publicity and creatives, you have to actively coordinate with these committees to build the media posting I showed you a while ago, and the graphs and charts and interview videos and other materials that you might think will help market our tutorial sessions. And also, Zach will get us acquainted with the current tutor pool, so stay tuned. We need to also update the 10th tutorial's Canvas slide so that the burden does not anymore go to our creatives committee. And for your respective project head plans, I think Edric has articulated to me his own vision for the tutorials. I think Jovian has his own too. Just put those things into writing and similarly blot those tasks in our camp charts. So every time that we do this, we have questions to ask. Number one, how should we measure the effectiveness of our tutorial sessions? Is it practical to measure those data? Is it viable? What are our plans? What are our strategies? Plans is what we want to do. Strategies is what we should afford to do in light of some external limitations. How do I get the rest of LSS on board? Number three, how can we promote exchange, more interactions within our tutorial sessions? And lastly, how can we better recognize and reward our tutees? What are the best ways to market their credentials? So thank you so much for watching. I'm excited to be working with you all in this new form of tutorials. Edric and Jovian, I'm so excited to be working with you. I know that you have great insights. Just put them into writing. I will check them and I will read them. Thank you.